This video will show you how to use serially coupled equilibrium calculators, meaning that we will link multiple equilibrium calculators to complete our calculation. This is done for complex equilibrium conditions and in cases where the equilibrium calculation does not converge. The calculation is based on example T6 of the examples included in your software. This video will show two unrelated examples of serially coupled equilibrium calculators. The goal of the first example is to find the carbon content where FCC and BCC are equal for an iron chromium carbon steel with 10% chromium at 850 degrees. The first step is to find the carbon composition where only FCC and BCC are present. The point of this is to give us a good starting point for the actual calculation. To begin, open Thermo-Calc in the graphical mode and click on the single point equilibrium template. From the database drop-down menu, select the FE Demo database, then select the elements iron, chromium, and carbon. We already know that we want a system with 10% chromium, so set chromium to 10. We'll use the default values for iron and carbon. Next, select the Equilibrium Calculator 1 node and change the temperature to 850 degrees Celsius. We'll use the default values for everything else, so select Perform Tree at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, a table will appear in the results pane. We can see in the table that the only phases present are FCC and BCC, so we know that we have a good starting point for our composition to complete the actual calculation. If you're doing your own calculation and are having a hard time finding the correct phases, you can watch video number 2 in this series to learn how to do a step calculation to find good starting values. Simply step in carbon instead of temperature. Now that we have a good starting value, we can add another equilibrium calculator to find what we're actually looking for, the carbon content at which FCC and BCC are equal. Right-click on the Equilibrium Calculator 1 node, select Create New Successor, then Equilibrium Calculator. We now have a second equilibrium calculator that has the same configuration as the first. Select Equilibrium Calculator 2, then select Switch to Advanced Mode. We are looking for the carbon composition, so uncheck the box next to Composition, Carbon, so that it is variable. If you are using a newer version of Thermo-Calc, this field will be called Mass Percent Carbon, so uncheck that box. Add another condition and select Fixed Phase, BCC, 0.5. This means that we are looking for the point at which BCC equals half of the system, and by default, FCC equals the other half. Since the system is defined as 1 mole, half would be 0.5, so BCC would equal 0.5 moles, and FCC would equal the other 0.5 moles. Right-click on Equilibrium Calculator 2, select Create New Successor, and select Table Renderer. Check the box under Columns and select Composition, Carbon, Mass Percent. If you are using a newer version of Thermo-Calc, select Mass Percent of All Components, Carbon, Mass Percent. This will put the information we're looking for at the top of the table. Now select Perform. Once the calculation is complete, a second table will appear in the results pane, and the information we're looking for is right at the top. We can see that when BCC is 50% and FCC is 50%, carbon makes up 0.01801 mass percent of the alloy. Results may vary slightly with different versions of the software. So if your results are different by a fraction of a percent, your calculation is probably still correct. We're now done with the first example, so we'll begin the second calculation. The goal of the second calculation is to find the solidus temperature of an iron chromium carbon alloy with 10% chromium and 0.01% carbon. First, we must calculate a single point equilibrium, just as we did with the first example. Right-click on the system definer, select Create New Successor, then Equilibrium Calculator. Notice that the composition carried over from the system definer. These are two separate examples, but we can use the same system definer because the two sets of calculations use the same database and elements. Since we're using the same composition as in the first calculation, we'll leave it as it is. We will also try the same temperature that we used in the first example as a starting point, so set the temperature to 850 degrees Celsius. Remember, even though we are using the same composition as in the first example, this is a completely separate set of calculations. Now right-click on Equilibrium Calculator 3, select Create New Successor, and Table Renderer. Then select Perform at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, a third table will appear in the results pane. Since this is the same calculation as the first one, the results are the same as those in Table Renderer 1. Now we will complete our fourth and final calculation. Right-click on Equilibrium Calculator 3, select Create New Successor, then Equilibrium Calculator. This calculator also has the same configuration as the first three. Select Equilibrium Calculator 4, then select Switch to Advanced Mode. We are looking for a temperature, so uncheck the box next to Temperature so that it is variable. Add another condition, select Fix Phase, Liquid, and make sure it is set to 0.0. Here, Fix means that the status fixed phase must be stable and be at equilibrium at a specified amount. We are looking for the solidus temperature, so if we set liquid to 0, we will get 100% solid. Next, right-click on the Equilibrium Calculator 4 node, select Create New Successor, and Table Renderer. Now select Perform at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, a fourth table will appear in the results pane. If you check the box next to temperature, that information will appear at the top. The solidus temperature of this alloy is 1790.6 Kelvin. Again, results may vary slightly with different versions of the software. So if your temperature is a degree or two different, your calculation is probably still correct. We hope you find this example useful. We have many other examples available, and we're constantly working to create new ones. So check back regularly at www.thermocalc.com.